The next point is on non-qualifying operations. So the question goes like this. Following operations taking place in a NAFTA country will not qualify a non-NAFTA product as a NAFTA product. All right. Change in end use. So what is change in end use? We actually have a good example here. Going back to 2009, where customs have been proposed with a question. We have a spent lead acid batteries under this particular HTS number. Imported in Canada under this subheading. So here is the point. In Canada, when they came into the Canada, they were so batteries. In Canada, they were classified as 8548. But then they were used up. So what do you do with them once they're used up? Well, whatever these guys do with them, probably recycle them. The classification for the used batteries is different than classification for the non-used batteries. So once the battery becomes spent, it changes to a tariff classification to 8507.10. And all this change takes place in Canada, right? So the question is, the question is, is there enough transformation, right? If we take a look at the change at the rules of origin, so we're going to go to 10220, our tariff shift rule provision. And we'll just scroll to the 8548. is available right here, and says a change to any to heading 8548 from any other heading. So heading is first four digits. Right, a change took place from this heading to this heading, right? All right, so under this tariff shift methodology, this means that the 10220 tariff shift has been met. This means that at least under the marking rules, Canada is a country of origin, so the spent batteries qualify for NAFTA. But wait. Here's what CBP, Customs and Border Protection, has said. A foreign material shall not be considered to have undergone an applicable change in tariff classification or to have met any applicable requirements merely by reason of the change in end use. And then customs goes on to say, use of the imported spent lead acid battery has changed from being a device that can store electricity and supply it when required to a device that is neither usable or of being recharged. And then they say its end use has changed. So battery remains a battery, only it's no longer usable. It is I mean, you not no longer usable for derivation electricity, maybe usable for recycling, but it's end use from providing electricity to end use of providing parts for recycling has changed. But change in end use is not a criteria, so change in end use kills this provision. So no NAFTA for this one, because it's merely a change in end use. So this is how, this is the tricky interplay between between the 102.17 section and 102.20, because under 102.20 it may look good, right? But if the end use has changed and nothing else has changed, then it doesn't matter. So the point here, the point here being, and this is applicable in the real world as well as in the customs broker license exam, that just by looking at 102.20 and putting a check mark may not be enough. You have to know the whole regulatory text. You have to know the context. You have to see the big picture. Just looking at one particular regulation and putting a check mark is not enough. Is not enough for you to make a determination. And as the end use lead storage electric battery showed. So change use is one. Which of the following shall be considered to have undergone applicable change in tariff classification that have been marked as originating in Canada? All right. Chinese origin plant cutting growth to maturity in Canada. All right, so plant cuttings. And one good example would be, let me go to the harmonized tariff schedule and put in one number. So let's do the plant chapter, which is a chapter 6. So as you can see, cut flowers are different, 0603, are different from those that plants, including the live plants with the roots, right? So cut flowers are really in a distinct category field. So based on this, if we look at the plant cuttings, right, it's the plants with the roots and plants that are cut have become a different product. They have become a different, they can become in a different heading, classification heading. So this makes it distinct. Is it applicable under the following, right? So there is no parts, there is no dilution, there is no simple packing, there is no dismantling or disassembly, right? It's a plant, right? How you can dismantle or disassemble the plant? A change in end use? Well, it's difficult to argue that big of a change. Plant is a plant, right? So unlike the battery example, which the change was in end use was to provide electricity and then to be used for recycling, this change in the plant end use is to really provide a plant product, whether for agricultural purposes or for aesthetic purposes. So A is something which is a correct answer choice because they have met this requirement. Chinese origin articles that undergo change in end use. Okay, this is change in end use, just like with the batteries, and change in end use is explicitly excluded. So B is excludable. Chinese origin electric motors dismantled or disassembled in Canada. Dismantling and disassembly is also prohibited under section 102.18. So B, C is incorrect. D, Chinese toys packed or repacked in Canada. All right, simple packing or repacking is also prohibited. And Chinese apple juice diluted with water and repacked to Canada, unlike in this example, dilution, they do not say there is material alteration. If they do say that, they make it explicit. Here, examiner says that dilution took place and no material alteration has taken place. Apple juice remained an apple juice, it's just less concentration, I suppose. Making E is also incorrect answer choice. A thing of notice when answering questions like this, I understand that providing a reason for plant cutting may be difficult at first. I showed you the example with HTS where from 06-03, where HTS US 06-03 is a separate heading for plant cuttings. I think the best way to approach this on the customs broker exam is the process of elimination, because here you have end use, dismantling, disassembly, packing, and dilution, which are explicitly stated and which can be explicitly excluded. And so my suggestion when answering a question like this is really to focus on the buzzwords here and eliminate those ones that stand out.